Hey guys, this is Jared from Men for Nerds, and we're trying something new today. This is going to be our first ever video review, and if all goes well, we'll do more in the future. There is already a written review on Persona 5 on our website, which I'll link in the description box down below. With that said, here's what we thought of Persona 5. Persona 5 is a role-playing video game developed by Atlus, but despite the name, Persona 5 is not the direct sequel to Persona 4, a game I absolutely adored and is in my top 10. The story revolves around a high school student who lives out a single year while attending school in Tokyo. The player is sent to live with a miserable, unfriendly old bastard. Funnily enough, after he stops a woman from getting raped. But rather than praise, thanks, and a slap on the back, he gets probation. Because Japan, and you don't interfere with sexual deviancy in Japan. Like the previous games, you and a group of high schoolers must work together to kill demons and change the world for the better. A pretty tall order for a bunch of teenagers and their prick cat. The overall story of the game is smart, it's interesting, and it's pretty damn entertaining, but the connecting elements between the main plot for around the first third of the game, I think, are so damn lazy it is insulting to the player. Rather than contrive a good reason to drive the plot forward, the writers relied on the main character being blackmailed not once, twice, but six fucking times in a row. Yes, six times in a row. You get blackmailed. I mean, there's no other reason you could contrive. Nothing else springs to mind. Nope, just blackmail. Whatever. Fair enough. We're here to kill demons. Let's move on. But then we have the characters. The NPCs. Your friends. The guys that you're building your relationship with. This is the part that gave me the most pause for reflection. Well, the characters each have a rich backstory. They've got real flaws, real emotions, and they're all working on personal issues like you would expect. The majority of them are such pricks when you first interact with them. I honestly had no desire to learn anything more about them. Unlike in Persona 4 Golden, where the characters are intriguing from the get-go, and you're enticed into wanting to know more about them and learn more about them, Persona 5's cavalcade of perverts and blackmailers makes you just wish there was a spit-in-face button. For example, one character tries to blackmail your female friend into posing nude for a painting. Let that just sink in for a minute. High school students. He wants to paint her in the nude. Fair enough, I guess. Whatever. But after all that's done and you've killed his like evil stepdad who might have poisoned his mom, who knows? He wants to sleep in your sofa because of course he does. And then you can't turn around and say no because the prick fucking cat that won't shut the fuck up invited him to stay. But rather than saying, no, you can't, I hate you, we end up spooning him with the bastard and taking him to dinner. Anyway, while I will admit to liking each of the characters about the games, and I have to say the only reason I did it was to get the special abilities that you get from getting to know them better. Moving on to what I dislike, we'll get the negative stuff out of the way first. The illusion of choice is the most infuriating thing in this game. I mean, why give us dialogue options if you're just going to make us play your game your way? I mean, I have nothing against the linear story. I mean, some of the best video games are linear. Just don't bullshit us and let us think that it's choice-based. That's all I'm saying. I think the reason it's so obvious in Persona 5 is because rather than making the decisions from the player's perspective, like in a linear story, like you did in Persona 4, i.e. I'm too sleepy to go out, I think I'll go to bed, or I've got a test in the morning, I can't go out and do stuff. In Persona 5, it has the fucking prick cat telling you, you're too sleepy, you gotta go to bed, or no, you can't go out and do this. When he writes, seeing my person would have grabbed the cat by the fucking neck and fucked him against a wall. I was also put off by how dark this game was. While the previous game was a murder mystery and contained all the death and violence any sane man had any right to hope for, we were introduced to it slowly. In this one, however, the first bad guy is a child abusing, molesting volleyball coach. Turns out the whole fucking school knows and are hushing it up. The parents have heard their rumours. How in the name of Satan's fetid foreskin does that scenario play out? Mommy, daddy, the mean volleyball coach punched me in the mouth and called me a whore.
Can he help you get into college?
I guess so, but I can taste blood.
Walk it off, champ.
Fuck you, parents of Persona 5! With that said, you could be forgiven for thinking that I hate Persona 5 based on everything I've just said, but I don't. There's so much to love about the game. Visually, it's amazing. The game has got this cartoony anime art style that just looks gorgeous on PS4. The stark contrast between the in-game real world versus the dungeons, it's just remarkable. It's always colourful and vibrant, even the in-game real world, but even when you're in the dungeon, it's got this wondrous, fantastical feel about it. It is just really gorgeous to look at. Like its predecessor, Persona 5's music is the big dog's biscuit. There's always music playing in the background, lending itself to any situation, creating a great atmosphere. In particular, the battle music. While some in-game bosses would have you snapping controllers in frustration at the third failed attempt and fucking looking at you, Dark Souls, I found myself smiling with Persona 5 because it meant I could listen to the badass final boss music again. And it's the same with almost every boss. They have all got their individual music. Now, the in-game battle music can get a little tedious, one battle after another. That can be forgiven. Also, I will have to say, despite the fact that I've only gotten to know them better because of the promise of in-game reward, I did find the characters interesting and sympathetic. And you've got the beautiful, attractive girl who's unjustly labeled easy. The put-upon little sister with high expectations thrust upon her. The young man who sacrifices his one passion just to survive. And then you have the cat who wants to bone the hot girl. Well, no, fuck that last man. Fuck that cat. I fucking hate that. Sorry about that. Anyway, where was I? Ah, yes. The gameplay. Finally, I have to mention the gameplay. I gotta say, Persona 5 knocked it out of the park. The gameplay is the best it's ever been. It surpasses its predecessor in both combat and in world exploration. Not only can you kill enemies, but you can also intimidate them, extort money or items out of them, or you can just get them to join forces with you, which adds this gotta catch them all Pokemon kind of vibe, which will really make the 100% completionist nutters very happy. I don't have the time to do something like that there, but if you do, more power to you, you mad bastard. But here we are at the end, and what is my opinion? Well, it's a fun game. At the end of the day, it is fun. You will get your money's worth out of this game. It's got an interesting story, interesting characters for the most part. They're a bit of a slog at the very beginning, but they're going to be assholes at the beginning because, well, everyone's an asshole. And the more you get to know them, the more they open up. So yeah, it's rewarding in that way as well. And great combat, great art style, awesome music. So yeah, if you're interested in JRPGs, pick it up. Okay, well, that's our first review. So if you liked it, like and subscribe, leave a comment. If you want to read any more of our stuff, go to nfornerds.com. You'll find us on nfornerds on Twitter, nfornerds on Instagram, nfornerds on Facebook, nfornerds on Patreon as well. Guys, thanks for listening. Take it easy.